everybody. Welcome to this week's Sunday School lesson. This week's lesson is going to revolve around the scripture from Matthew. It's Matthew chapter 13, verses 44 through 52. And so before I start the lesson, I'm going to read the scripture to you. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and covered up. Then in his joy, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls, who, on finding one pearl of great value, went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and gathered fish of every kind. When it was full, men drew it ashore and sat down and sorted the good into containers, but threw away the bad. So it will be at the end of the age, the angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace. At that place, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all of these things? They said to him, yes. And he said to them, therefore, every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like a master of a house who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old. So that's the scripture that we're going to do our lesson with today. And so first we're going to talk about a parable. So the stories that Jesus told in that scripture were what are called parables. And parables are stories of Jesus's teachings. And Jesus told his followers many parables about the kingdom of God. And so here's a picture of Jesus teaching his followers. And in this one, it's really more about the kingdom of God and what a treasure that kingdom is. Do you know what a kingdom is? It's a place where everybody does what the king says. So if you choose to live in the kingdom of God, then you want to do what God says because he is the king. So no matter where you are in the world, you can be a part of God's kingdom. When people think about kingdoms, they usually think about riches and treasures. And Jesus wanted his followers to know that the kingdom of God is more valuable than any treasure in the world. So he went around teaching his word about the kingdom of God. So in the scripture that I read, he talked about the man in the field. And so here's the man in the field. He was digging in the field and he came across a treasure that was buried out in the field. And he decided that he would bury the treasure back up and then he would go home and sell everything that he had so that he could come back and buy the field. He thought that that was more valuable than everything else that he had. So he was able to come back and buy the field with the treasure in it. So the point of the story that Jesus was trying to tell was that this man was willing to give up everything that he had so that he could have something more valuable. Sometimes we have to give up things so that we can obey God and be a part of his kingdom. So sometimes we have to give up things like fighting with our brothers and sisters or maybe saying words that we shouldn't say so that we can be obeying God's rules to be a part of his kingdom. And another story that he told was about a merchant. And this merchant, he would hunt for pearls and he would buy those pearls at a lower cost and then sell them for a higher price. And that's how he made his living. And one day he came across a pearl that he knew was going to be the most valuable pearl that he ever found. And so he sold everything that he had so that he would have enough money to buy that pearl. Jesus wants us to know that the kingdom of heaven is so valuable that we have to be willing to give up things to be a part of it. So sometimes we have to give up some of the things that we have so that we can be a part of God's kingdom. Once we have found the treasure of eternal life and love of God through Christ, the search for treasure for more treasure is unnecessary. So this guy found the most valuable pearl that he could find. And he bought it, and then his search for more pearls was over. So when we find that treasure with God, our search for further treasure is over. Christ paid the ultimate price for us to be a part of this kingdom. So I want you to think about, what would you be willing to give up to be a part of the kingdom of God? What are some things out there that maybe you're doing that maybe isn't obeying what God wants you to do? And then sometime this week when you have some time, I want you to make yourself a poster. Like this one that we made here at my house. It says, God is my treasure. Let me put a little treasure box here. Because we want to remember that once we find the kingdom of God, we found the ultimate treasure. So I hope you enjoyed my message this week. Thank you.